Good morning, everyone. My name is Connor Postman.
And I'm Peyton Zong.
We created the Frankenpot. So many of you may know Frankenstein, the story of Frankenstein. He creates his own monster called Frankenstein's Monster. But if you've read the book or seen an adaptation of the book, you know that he loses his creature in the end. Spoiler alert. So we decided that he's getting a little lonely, so he's going to need a companion for himself. So knowing that there's not an excess of body parts laying around to create a new Frankenstein, he decides to go to the local junkyard and buy himself a 3D printer. So he gets together some little pieces and opens up his CAD and starts to design his own little, his new little friend.
So our target group for the Frankenbot is because we want to talk the story of a little robot, of the monster and a little robot companion. We wanted to target it somewhere around the ages of 7+, but we didn't, because we didn't want it to target little kids because there are gears inside the robot, so we didn't want them to like scrape skin off their fingers. So we wanted to make sure they knew what they were doing. And if we were actually going to release this toy to the public, it would be around Halloween for you to keep it. We didn't want to release it around Easter days, because that would make no sense whatsoever. So what can Frankenbot do? So the goal of our robot, of our project, was to have it move the legs in a forward, up and down motion, so it can go forward, and while also attaching the arms to the legs, so that the arms kind of accompany the legs when it moves. It's kind of in the way Frankenstein's monster does in this animation. And of course, we wanted to make it look pretty as possible. Not as pretty, as frightening as possible. So I'm going to talk a bit about the exterior view right now. So the theme, I don't know if you can see Frankenstein's face on that Creole model, but it is on there. And we wanted to keep with the theme of our toy, that since Frankenstein's monster was built with spare parts and kind of like junk, so we wanted to keep a theme that you can build this robot with whatever materials you have, not necessarily just acrylic sheets that we used and 3D printed parts. As long as you keep the core inside of it, for Frankenstein's monster, that core was the heart. For our robot, it's the cross gear and the section that keeps the legs and arms moving. So we printed several acrylic sheets and used epoxy to glue the outside case together. And we have the battery holder in the back. And you can see the arms and the legs moving as well. And of course we drew Frankenstein's face onto the robot.
Well, here's a little snapshot of the inner works. So you see we created a cross gear with a helix and a worm. And worm gear. So here's the leg. There's a snapshot of that a little closer up later. So here's a little animation of his motion. You see his legs moving up and down, and he's kind of walking like Frankenstein. So here is our 3D printed leg. We created a slot, two different slots, one for the cam to move in, as well as the arm moves in the slot up in this area. here is our worm and worm gear. Attached with is a DC motor. Here's some pictures of our prototype. As you can see here, here's a back view of it. You can see here we got our gear and our two legs. And these arms connect straight into the slots. So when those legs move, it just moves with those slots. So. Do we have any questions about our project? Unfortunately, we were not able to make our real physical prototype work due to excessive friction in the gears. Our DC motor is not strong enough, so we can't demonstrate our toy at this time.
So what were the plans for, would it run off of batteries?
Yeah, we got a battery pack right here.
And what are the batteries?
Just double A's, anyone can get some double A's and plug them in there.
Kidding,
we got a switch right there.
I didn't know how much we needed to make it, actually.
If in the future, we may have to upgrade our motor or shrink it down, and we may have to upgrade the output of the batteries.
Yeah, can you lift it so we can see it in the background?
That's alive.
I want to see the yellow face so it looks scary. Turn around the computer.
He's
smiling. Okay.
So the main problems we had with the actual physical prototype is the motor spins at a really reasonable RPM, but it just doesn't provide enough additional torque to keep the cross gear moving because it's such a huge gear. And we think the 3D printed material might provide too much friction as well. So when we turn the motor on, the cross gear doesn't move with it.
So what are you looking at to solve that?
Well, two of our ideals is to shrink the entire thing so it's not only can we make it more movable, but also we can change the design because we're limited by the volume area of the design. So you can see it's kind of blocky now. If we shrunk the design, we could have made it more, I don't want to say prettier, but more appealing. And also our second idea is to use a different motor that provides a much stronger torque so the cross gear can't.
Only two of you that work on.
No, we have another team member, but he's in Detroit, I think, for interviews, so he can't be here. So ideally, the robot should move as in the same way the animation does.
And if you're any cost estimates, what do you expect the cost?
So we were provided a budget of $60. We used about $60. So I'm assuming that if we, that main cost was this acrylic material. So hopefully in the future, if we can reduce the size of this, we 3D print the body as well, which will reduce our costs.